don't know what she's talking about. Just stand down. You're doing too much. But this is great Twitter gold. Everybody on Twitter loves the uninformed person hopping into local politics.
I think that's a leap, though, to say he's not informed. Look, we may know.
What does he know about Texas politics?
I have not interviewed him yet to know that, but maybe he has done some research about it to the point where he knows he's a global brand and he wouldn't wear the hat and then someone said, hey, what do you know about it?
Somebody told him to do it.
Well, somebody may have, but he may have been interested in it, too. But that said, athletes can be more than just an athlete, so you can't have your
be experts on Texas politics living in L.A. and Ohio. Darnell, what's next?
All right, moving on to Marcellus Clippers.
Oh, yeah.
Who honored former guard Austin Rivers with his tribute video on the Jumbotron when the Wizards played at Staples Center last night. Rivers had some good moments for the Clippers, but will mostly be remembered for being the son of Coach Doc Rivers.
What?
Lakers writer Bill Oren threw some shade at the team when he tweeted, will he be the first Clipper to have his jersey retired, too?
Oh, my God.
Marcellus, do you like your Clippers paying tribute to Austin Rivers?
Man, I have so many jokes for you, Bill, right there. Chill out, man. Clip City, Chip City. I heard the producer say, be quick about my Clippers. I shall not. This team is overachieving right now. My team was a fifth seed right now. We out here balling out of control. Respect to Austin Rivers, who improved every single year he was with the Clippers and turned into a very good player.
Did they run his birth certificate on the jumbo screen? That was his contribution to the Clippers.
What, Doc Rivers?
Daddy Doc Rivers. That's what they should have run. All right.
Leave that man alone.
What's next?
Let's talk a little college football. Where Oklahoma State upset Texas this weekend thanks to the big play of quarterback Taylor Cornelius. Cornelius has had an up-and-down season replacing former Cowboy quarterback Mason Rudolph, often taking heat on Twitter. So outspoken head coach Mike Gundy was quick to defend his quarterback against all
he's
fans.
A man!
In the post-game press conference, take a listen.
I give a rat's ass about Twitter. A platform for people that are sitting home throwing a unemployment check, sitting in front of a keyboard. I just kind of felt like that social media and Twitter is what's destroying this country anyway. So that's how I feel about it, from politics to sports to whatever.
We love Mike Gundy.
What?
Love it. We got to send him some Twitter off for his next press conference.
Oh, my.
Mike, I'm going to send you a bottle of this Twitter off.
Yeah.
Love it.
You found your spirit animal, didn't you? Huh? Hope y'all can just walk around with partly cloudy skies every day.
What the heck? It's just words. It's just keyboards. It's just like little
divisive hate being spread all over the world.
Dude, he is a grown man rocking a mullet. I'm not trying to hear
dirt.
That mullet is dividing our country more than the Twitter world. Come on, man. You either mullet in or you mullet out. You mullet in. You mullet.
I can't touch that one, so I got to go. What's next, Darnell?
All right. Moving on to little Drizzy Drake. The rapper / NBA superfan had a concert at Oracle Arena and wore this Kevin Durant snakeskin jersey. Twitter loves calling KD a snake for his decision to join Golden State. But do you think Drake went a little too far wearing this in the Warriors' home arena?
This blows my mind.
Oh, you think it's that? You think that is this?
A snakeskin jersey with Kevin Durant?
He's been wearing a lot of snakeskin lately.
With Kevin Durant's number on it.
The Scorpions have skin? Because his last album was Scorpion. So get the Scorpion skin. I don't know what the hell.
He's calling KD a snake in his own building, man.
That ain't how Drake rolls.
It's bold.
Yeah, but Drake doesn't roll like that. Like, he's the ultimate cheerleader for every team that he likes and represents. So he never brings the smoke. He never brings the hate. So I can't see him bringing the smoke. I just think that he's like, all right, let's do something different, show you that I'm Drake, and I'm going to have a different material.
Well, this is tone deaf then.
Yeah,
and
there
someone should have told him that's not the thing to do to Kevin Durant.
He knew it for sure. I think it's a joke. I think KD and Drake, they're good friends.
Right.
They often joke and play around with each other. I think he's very aware of what he was doing.
Tone deaf, maybe. I give you tone deaf.
Kevin
like
Durant
that.
May hop on a diss track, drop 16 bars, go push a T on.
Right. We heard him freestyle back in the
day. As long as it ain't LeBron on that track. LeBron can't rap. But KD, he got bars.
Right.
All right, Darnell, what's next?
All right, so I was watching The Herd this morning, and our guy Colin was kind of reacting to all the Cleveland messes going on today, and had an idea on kind of how to help the Browns out. Take a listen.
Cleveland's a mess. This Baker Mayfield thing has to work. The only chance for the Cleveland Browns to end this 20-year, two-decade abyss, the Baker Mayfield has to work. I'd go to Oklahoma and hire his coach, Lincoln Riley.
He had me until he said I'd go to Oklahoma and hire a 36-year-old to be the head coach of the Cleveland Browns. why walk Lincoln Riley into this mess in the NFL? He's got no experience there. I do believe in him in terms of it's a mess. Cleveland needs the Baker Mayfield thing to work. I don't think Lincoln Riley's the answer, though.
Lincoln Riley's not the answer, and it's because Lincoln Riley should stay in Oklahoma. One, when you're a young coach, and you have that type of job security, which you will have out there. And look at Bob Stoops. What did he coach for? 2 decades out there in Oklahoma? One, you get paid more at the collegiate level. Nick Saban's making $10 million a year, highest paid employee in the state of Alabama, and the job security that comes with that. I think the world knows that if you can do it in college, stay still versus going to the pros where there's so much turmoil and job insecurity.
Cowherd, I know, watches this show religiously because he follows my takes so he can reuse them. Cowherd, let me tell you who they should hire. It's obvious. He's just up the street. Urban Meyer is the guy you hire if you're the Cleveland Browns. You throw every dollar you got at him, and you let Urban Meyer try to fix Baker Mayfield.
I mean, look, we made a lot of noise about John Gruden getting a 10-year, $100 million deal, right?
Yeah.
Just add up what Nick Saban's going to make in his 10 years, like the last 2 years. He's going to trump $100 million with the job security that I could go out there and fail a couple years, which he won't, and still be there protected. You don't get that in the NFL. I would not go to the NFL. Nobody.
If I'm Urban Meyer, I do after I've, you know, things at Ohio State aren't the greatest. Next best challenge. Thank you, Darnell. Awesome job. Coming up, the Cleveland Browns decided to move on from Hugh Jackson today. We've got our approval ratings for Hugh.